Glacier, and we are stopping for some lunch, and it's amazing. So beautiful. There's snow. There's some waterfall over there.
There goes the rock.
And it's kind of steep.
Yeah.
Nathan, stop throwing rocks, please.
Waterfalls everywhere you look. See that pretty waterfall? That long waterfall.
And
headed
look
up down there.
At this rock.
Come on down to Dina and Malia's Mountaintop Restaurant. We get all the finest sandwiches and Doritos and all kinds of stuff. Best views of
applesauce.
Applesauce too. Sitting at our mountainside cafe. And this is the landscape. And it even had angels. Beautiful waterfall. A couple of pretty cool mountain girls.
I heard we saw the mountain goats running around up there before.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Well, it wasn't running, it was walking. But.
It's just eye candy everywhere you look. It's pretty amazing. There's the girls waiting for the bathroom. Malia, Lily!
I don't think it's an animal.
No. Yeah. We are on a little scenic hike at Sun Point, overlooking this magnificent lake. And there he is. He's trailblazing. We send the strong men up front to make sure there are no bears. And remember, guys, we need to be talking loud.
Yeah.
Look at that. That is amazing.
Hey, bear.
Hey, bear. And we're walking back. That water is a pretty ridiculous color right now. Having fun in the water on Lake McDonald. Careful there, Nate. Nathan is having a hard time keeping his back. He's the only one out there. And there is Malia and Dina and Michaela. Hey Nathan, be careful, buddy.
He's joking with you. Ouch, Kaylin.
Uh-oh, Lily's down.
Oh no,
Lily!
They're getting ready to go in the bumper cars. There's Lily and Kate and Michaela on this side. And we have Steve and Malia and Nate on that side. Ooh, see what happens when you leave me in charge of your camera?
Go!
Here comes Nate. He's ahead of Malia. And Michaela. And Steve.
Mudman Burger is voted the best burger in the valley, 2017, 2018, and 2019. What happened in 2020, Mudman?
A little bitty house like that over there against the railroad tracks.
We even looked at a house down there.
Yeah, we looked at a couple of them over there, and they ended up being backing up against the railroad tracks. Like, no.
Okay. Don't do that. We lived in a house for a year, but next to the railroad tracks, so nice to you.
Yeah. We are driving home from Glacier, and Malia is driving. Look at that. And everybody seems to be okay with it, except for Michaela. Because she has been clutching her seat. There is a bald eagle sitting up on the fence post. We ended our last night in Montana by coming out to Lake Coconusa to do a little sunset swimming. Yeah, it was fun.
It was amazing.
Yeah, so, Lily back away. So, we've done pretty well in Montana, and we're so thankful that we have family here that we're able to guide us around and show us what was what. Day 10, and we are leaving Mike and Dina's house. We are going west through the great state of Idaho and Washington, and we are bedding down in the state of Washington. Not the nation's capital, but the nation's most northwesterly state in the lower 48. Deer out there this morning. Man, we've lucked out with the weather, and this has not rained at all. We are about 10 miles northwest of Troy, Montana. Montana. And we are getting ready to cross into the great state of Idaho. We are going right along with the Kootenai River, so we're able to, this whole drive this morning has been right by a body of water, which is really cool. Look guys, there's a payphone.
Bye to Montana, and hello Idaho.
Hello Idaho.
Welcome to Idaho.
We gotta get some taters up in here. That's where I get my taters.
We are headed to Bonner's Ferry. It'll be beautiful, especially this time of year. Be able to bed down in Kennewick, Washington tonight, God willing. And until then, we are driving through the mountains. We're going up and down and sideways.
Here we are in Bonner's Ferry. Looking at all the little rivers coming through. Got the little clock tower over here in town.
Kootenai Casino and Spa.
Casino and Spa.
Yeah. I'm gonna go play blackjack and go get your hair did. That's pretty cool.
Very cool.
Lake Coconala. That's what they call it.
Coconala.
Yeah. It rolls off the tongue. Actually, literally rolls off the tongue. Coconut.
It's pretty. Right there. That's it.
It's a billboard.
City of Post Falls thanks you.
Well, you're welcome, Post Falls. Hit Spokane in about 15 minutes. And yeah, another checkpoint on our big trip. Welcome to Washington sign. We are in Washington. This is Spokane, Washington. And we are just driving through. We're not stopping and visiting. You know, it's We only got 2 hour push to Kennewick, Washington. I'm sure it's a lovely city. We wouldn't be able to tell you any different though. But now we can say that we've been to Spokane, the Franny Dodgers restaurant. Spokane, whatever.
Carl's Jr.
What?
AKA Parties.
Good times in Spokane, Washington. Eastern Washington, a lot of high desert, but we have this little oasis. Not sure what lake this is, but it's about 20 miles west of the Idaho-Washington border. Old freight train in Eastern Washington. Look at her go. They got two locomotives on the front going in an old train. It's like a dust bowl behind it. You see that? It's like a dustnado. We are pulling into the Tri-City area, which is...
Keep right to US 395 South.
Kennewick. In Pasco, and then I don't know the other.
Richland.
Anybody want some trains? There's a bunch of them. Coming into Kennewick and crossing the Columbia River. Magnificent bridge, which I'm sure saves a lot of time. Wow, that is beautiful. Alright, day 11, and we just woke up in Kennewick, Washington, and had some breakfast, got some coffee, did a failed drone shoot, which should be interesting footage. We're headed to Lincoln City, Oregon. It'll take about 5 hours and 3 minutes, and then we will, God willing, arrive in Lincoln City and get to enjoy the beach for another day. Cozumel, the best sopapilla I've ever had. How you doing, sweetie?
I'm doing good.
Yeah? What are you looking forward to today?
Going to the coast and swimming.
Hey, hey, in the water?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see how cold it is. Bring all you got. Headed south, and we are getting ready to cross the river. And we will be in Oregon. Malia's taking us to Oregon today.
Hell.
She knows the way. They gotta have a welcome to Oregon sign, right? This is awkward.
Say a visitor center back there.
Driving along the Columbia River on the Oregon side. It is beautiful. We are in Portland, Oregon. If you would believe it, we made it all the way to Portland, and we're looking for the Antifa. I got the tents set up. Last year they basically took over a big chunk of downtown Portland and made it their own. And there was drug use and all kinds of different crimes that were occurring. That's what happens when you don't have police.
Caitlin is a Sudoku master.
What's the next number going to be?
It's going to be a 1. Feel it. Okay, maybe it's not a 1.
Oh, what a waste of video. Nathan's up there navigating. Man, he's the map man. And he's making a playlist too. He's a multitasking little 10-year-old. He's not little anymore. 10 years old. Man. And he's keeping mom company. Get yourself a Malia and a Nathan and you are good. I have my unicorn neck pillow. I fit right in Portland. What are you looking at? Malia, I love you.
I love you more.
We're listening to our white people music. America. Downtown Portland. I got it. Portland, Oregon. Pacific Highway on the way to Lincoln City. We see some big plane. Hey, just put it right there, Roger. That'll work. All right, Evergreen. Yeah. We're headed to see the Pacific Ocean. Very specific about it. Not the Atlantic, not the Gulf, the Pacific. And
Lighthouse Square. 60s Cafe, Hub Fish and Chips.
There it is, our first glimpse of the Pacific Ocean. Right ahead there. Look at that, isn't that? The largest ocean in the world. Right there in front of our eyes. We stopped at the Hilltop Restaurant. Well, how was your meal?
Good. Yeah. Wonderful, probably good. Better than everybody's here.
Oh, really? She got the fish sandwich? Kate got the club sandwich. Lily got the mac and fries.
Macaroni and cheese with applesauce.
With applesauce, yeah. Okay, thank
and
you.
Water.
And water. Ooh, water.
And the water.
And then Big Nate had them corn dogs and tater. French fried tater. Here we are, the Pacific Ocean, all of its splendor. It's a chilly, chilly day out on the coast. Beach mama. You all right?
Are you all right?
I know I'm not all right.
Yeah, we've done that for some time.
Do you not have a sweatshirt?
And Nathan and Lily are up to sticking their feet into the water.
About now is the time that they should be stopping. Lily is still going. Caleb's done.
Oof. And here they go, just as awkwardly as they walk down. Alright, this kid's, she's just digging a hole. She has been since we've came down. She's using no tools, just the will to build a hole for, yeah, for we don't know. We don't know what her objective is. They go, two of them, going back out there for more chaos and carnage.
What? No.
What are you taking that out for?
Because.
We stopped at our hotel. House kind of, but here's the beautiful, beautiful beach. And
welcome to this hotel room. So I walked up the steps. There's four chairs. Wait, one, two, three. Yeah. And then there's a hot tub. There's a literal hot tub right here, and you can't see it, but it's there. And then we just open this door. Ugh, so we can get it open. Oh, okay, let me go. Hey, Dad. I think the door's locked. There's Dad going to help me because I can't do it. Okay, thank you. And we just got in here, so it's a little bit dirty. And some cool seashells. Really cool seashells. Here's the kitchen. And the phone. And then there's Nathan. The curtains are not out. Here's two couches. My pink ball. And the TV. And there is some games in there that just came with the hotel. Of course, we won't take them and steal them, of course. And this is Mom and Dad's room. It's a nice room. A beachy little theme to it. And this door opens up to the bathroom. And there's me. And here's her glorious bed. And then here's the awesome view. The most awesome view here. And that's goodbye for now.
All right, we are at Chinook's Seafood Restaurant. We are waiting to be seated, even though we are seated right now. How's it going, fam?
Good.
What?
Going good.
Can we just think about how cool that is? Look at that. The sun is going down. And we're eating clams. All right, day 12. Just woke up a little bit ago. I guess the girls have been up for a while. And we are still in Lincoln City, Oregon. In a few hours, we're gonna make our trip back home, back east to Boise, Idaho. What do you think, gals? Yeah, we like our little temporary home here on the beach. It was nice. But nice cold morning. Caitlin and Malia woke up a little bit earlier and went and saw some cool stuffs. But life is good, and we will catch up later on. We are headed back east to Indiana. Back towards that direction. We just left Lincoln City a few minutes ago. We are headed east up through Portland and along the Washington-Oregon border for most of the day until we hit Kennewick and we go back south and towards Boise.
7th La Pine, or is that correct?
No! You didn't wait for me to finish, you silly bugger!
And then there's Dad, and of course he's driving, and I don't know why he has his hand off the wheel.
Here we go.
Welcome
to Idaho. We like to run around in our fields. Only state in the whole trip that we visited twice. Because it's so nice.
So nice. We visited two times.
Yeah.
Oh, I did some embroidery. Do you want to see?
Yes, I do want to see it. Ooh! There it is!
There it is! There it is!
Do that.
Craters of the Moon. National Monument. We have normal looking Idaho dirt, dried grass, and to the right is a lava wasteland. Houston, we have landed on the moon. We are officially in Craters of the Moon National Park.
I've read all the books.
And there's Nathan and Lily talking literature. Look at these little white vegetation of some kind. And there's the rest of the crew. What's Nathan doing? Hey Nathan, what you doing, pal?
Getting all the rocks in my shoes that keeps getting back in.
I love that crunching noise. It is kind of steep and slippery. Just look at that tree. It's a weird tree. It's a cool tree. Look at that. Just look at it. That's it for now.
So Steve thinks this is a volcano.
Kind of looks like a volcano.
Another volcano right there. Gotta zoom in.
You can't see her, but she's doing air quotes every time she says volcano.
Steve has planned our evacuation route in case lava starts flowing over the city.
We just crossed the Wyoming state line. This is officially Wyoming. We're about 19 miles out from Jackson Hole. Looks like we're going down in the elevation. Lily thinks it's cool. Nathan says, man.
Amazing.
I have a feeling we're gonna run into some more wildlife around here.
Says, howdy stranger, yonder is Jackson Hole, last of the old west. Down there is a hole, and it's called Jackson. Jackson Hole, Wyoming. Place. Hey, truck.
Hey, truck. You have reached. Those are all antlers.
And there is the arch made entirely out of antlers. Little park in the center of the town. And all four corners have those antler arches. Yeah. It's a real buffalo or bison. Howdy do. And Jackson Mercantile. Yeah, there is a lot. That dude. Heyo. We are walking through Jackson Hole. So we stopped at a little Indian restaurant in Jackson Hole. Who would have thought? And we sat right down. So we're looking forward to our little Indian cuisine.
We just got done eating, and Nathan and Dad want to go pick up the car while us girls are gonna go a little bit of shopping.
Nature hike.
I would take me with you.
We're going on a hike in the middle of a neighborhood.
Hi.
Oh. Up in the mountains.
Stopped at a little stream here.
It's a hot one.
It is hot. That's our view though. And this is how far we've got left to go.
They look like them. Yeah, they don't know.
And look at that view while we're on the trail up.
Hello. We are going back to our hotel.
It's day 14. It's a little past noon, and we are headed out to Grand Teton National Park. One of the most popular national parks. But it's about a 2-hour drive to get there. Hey, let's rent a teepee for the night there. We'll live like the Indians. Good job on taking that picture, Mom.
One more than yesterday.
Fish and bison on the hill, they're fake. There's some elk too, but they're fake too. There's Malia, she is all real.
I'm real.
Grand Teton National Park. This is our Airbnb. Going a little rustic. Free horse rides if you can catch them. I think Nathan's gonna get his own room on this one. Note, this is the Cunningham Cabin. It's in Grand Teton National Park.
It looks like a horse stall. What's
and
that?
If you looked out this window right here, it would be a beautiful shot of the mountains, but we just see smoky fog.
It's good.
I'm trying to decide if...
It's cool.
Well, he says it's good. It is good to be a horse out in Wyoming. What's up, pal? This is one of the coolest horses ever. We named her Betsy. That's nice. That horse right there is beautiful. She's coming down here, Lily. So, J. Pierce Cunningham used to be a rancher, and then he started talking too much, I guess, and the people around him were really annoyed because he just talked all the time, so that's why he is now a conversationalist. A little history for you. Some wild buffalo in Wyoming. Look at them just doing their thing, twirling their tails. And this little girl has been talking about buffalo the whole trip. She finally gets to see it, but can you count them?
There's a lot.
There's a lot of them.
It's really scary. This is charming.
Grand Teton National Park. Private vehicles, $35 a piece. But it's all good because we got this little deal. So we shouldn't even have to talk to anybody, but we do need a map, so we're gonna have to get the buyers that way. We are on a hiking path around Jackson Lake. There it is, what a view.
Lily, do you want your swim shoes?
American Pickers needs to get over here quick.
It is day 15. We woke up in Rigby, Idaho, and we are headed up to Yellowstone National Park.
What do you think Yellowstone's going to be like?
Lots of mountains and trees and animals.
And Mama is doing the driving this morning. She's doing a fine job. About 15 miles out of Yellowstone. It's been a nice, pretty mountain range here.
Sure, education is important, but vacation is important, Ginger.
Get a quaint little cabin right outside of Yellowstone. $800 a night.
Statue of a real buffalo.
And a chipmunk.
And Bobby the Beaver.
We got through the gate entrance, and we are in Yellowstone. This is it.
Madison River.
The Lower Geyser Basin.
Where's it?
And we don't know if that is an actual geyser spitting up water or what the dealio is.
The geyser. West Union. It's a hot spring. Okay.
Wow.
And there's another hot springs up close.
Look at those white things. Like, it's an outline of that. You said you liked. You said you liked hot tubs. Other than that, you wouldn't like hot tubs at all.
There's paint pots. That's what it's called. Tree in there. Random tree.
It's a boiling. It just sounds like there's like a big load of laundries down there. The Clepsydra geyser? What you got there, Galen?
Hand sanitizer. I'm going to hand sanitize my hands.
It doesn't say no parking on that rock.
What you doing? Filling out my water bottle with cold water.
I think that's a great fountain. A little nature hike. Big trees. Big tall trees.
It's like a rainbow.
It's not just a geyser.
It's an old faithful geyser.
It's old faithful because it faithfully erupts every 30 minutes to an hour and a half, which in our case, it probably just erupted and we have a full hour and a half wait.
There it is, Old Faithful. There is a line of people all along the edge.
So excited.
She's really excited. Nathan, what do you think, buddy? He's just happy to be here. Yeah. I like it.
I am looking forward to it.
Yeah, cool. She's going to take a time-lapse video. We come down here to watch geysers, to converse, and to get our hair did. That's an old faithful ponytail right there.
Here's Dad, here's Nathan, here's Mom, and here's Caitlin, and then here's me.
Oh no.
Whoa, no. Oh, and I stick up my hand because I'm just like.
I didn't say you couldn't.
Hey, girls.
Hey.
Caitlin dropped your phone in the water, but it's okay.
Crust area. Yellowstone Lake. Which is fed by the Yellowstone River. Mama. Little bitty hot springs coming out all over the place. Another thermal spring. It's pretty. It's pretty, pretty.
Hiya, buffalo.
Just remain calm. If he wants to cross, he is gonna cross. Here. Ooh. There's some more buffalo really close to the road. What's up, pal? Now he knows what he thinks about us. Under the trees there. Oh yeah. Day 16, just woke up, got the essentials packed up, and now we are headed to Rapid City, South Dakota.
Lillian spotted a moose on the interstate, so we were turning around and going back to see if we can't find the moose.
Up here, about a half mile, there's a big old herd of cows. Another dude on a horse. There's some wranglers. Driving further into southern Montana, and things are looking pretty gorgeous. Got some drone footage a while back, and it's pretty, pretty, pretty. Big Sky, Montana.
There's gold in them hills. We are on the edge of the tribal lands of Montana. How you doing?
I'm scared.
On hour, what?
Scared of
what hour are we on driving today?
Done 6.5 hours.
Look where Steve took us.
Stoneville slow.
Hey, buddy, what are you doing?
Oh, this is long.
So, here we are, just coming over the ridge in Wyoming to Devil's Tower.
We are approaching Devil's Tower. Devil's Tower. Hey, Emily, did you bring chapstick? Hi. All right, there it is.
Hello, we are in Wyoming, and we are about to go into South Dakota. Yeah.
And what are we gonna go see tonight?
Mount Rushmore.
Hey-ho. South Dakota.
Woo-hoo.
All right.
We did it.
So, just a little less than an hour, and we will be in Rapid City. This is Sturgis, South Dakota, home of the motorcycle show, which is in, I think, another week. This place will be popping.
I think it's real.
You guys, there is that dinosaur on top of that hill.
Ooh, dinosaur in these parts.
I feel
parks.
Like dinosaur. You guys should acknowledge that more.
There's our hotel right there, guys. See, the red says... Hotel Alex Johnson.
Alex Johnson. That's our hotel, yeah. Pretty little sunset. Coming up into Mount Rushmore. We got this little tunnel. South Dakota.
Check it, Kate.
It's a pretty cool looking town. Wow. Quite the setup.
Whoa, that's good. And we have arrived.
Washington, Jefferson, Roosevelt, and Lincoln in all of their splendor. And there are the Macaulays. Four great people. Four great people. Indiana's flag, and it is twisted. All right, day 17,
We woke up in Rapid City, South Dakota, and we quickly jumped out of bed and ran over to the Black Hill Bagel Company. Some local breakfast flavor. Now we're headed out to Badlands State Park. Not wasting any time.
And then over here are some more prairie dogs. Little fat ones right there.
Badlands and a good girl. Badlands National Park. It's basically one big jungle gym. You just climb over everything. There are no rules. Except to just enjoy God's beauty. And there is Nathan victoriously walking through the valley. We got kicked out of our hotel room, so we have to stay here tonight. There's Caitlin. There she is.
Make it more rocks.
Never a shortage of rocks.
Let's play I Spy. I Spy something gray.
Whoa, that was kind of scary.
That's a big one.
Here they are. There's Lily, and there's Kaylin, and there's Nathan. And there's the girls. Hi, Malia. Hi, Lily.
Hi.
There is Miss Yellowstone, 2021. There's Miss Glacier Bay, 2021. And there's the runner-up for Yellowstone. And there's Mr. Jamaica, 21. They're dressed like the tourists. But it's okay because everybody here is a tourist. No one makes a day trip. I don't know. Even the people who make day trips are tourists.
Oh yeah, that's
me. She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes. She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes. She'll be having her learner's permit. She'll be driving mom and dad's car. She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes. Good job coming around the mountain there, Caitlin. Drugstore.
Hey, yo.
What's up?
Prairie dog.
That's you.
We're in Wall Jet and we're having a good time. Lily got a pocket knife. That's my pappy right there. Here's my great uncle Zed. He's gonna go show us how to gold mine. There's his donkey. Wall Drugstore, and this place has expanded into an empire. Who is loving every minute of it, right, Mama? This is the first Trump store I've been in. Ever. Don't blame me, I voted for Trump.
I thought that was a
one. You're so pretty, Lily. Hey, Lily, what'd you get with your money today? Hey, does it say
it's
Lily?
It's too nice.
It does?
Uh-huh.
Wow, it's spelled the right way and everything. Hold it up.
It has two knives and scissors.
Nate's got his playing cards. He's wanting to make a deal. Make a deal? Let's make a deal. She is doing good. What'd you get there, Kate? Is that Lily's?
Yeah.
What'd you get today? Did you buy anything?
No, I didn't buy anything.
Caleb blew her whole wad in Minnesota.
I have $4.
Day 18, and we slept in Rapid City for the last time last night. We are headed to Omaha, Nebraska, which is a little bit over a 7-hour drive.
And we're approaching Iowa.
To Nebraska, and I was told that the first video made in Iowa was not satisfactory, so let's give a tour of Iowa. We are approaching Nebraska, and I don't know if you can see it, but right in front of us is a bridge,
Nebraska!
Woo!
Missed it. Hey, some backseat action going on. We got an Uno game.
Busting out again.
And who is that back there? Is that? Dad's in the back seat.
Alright. We are walking.
And a half miles
downtown Omaha.
To keep left to I-480 east towards downtown.
Oh, Spaghetti Works, not factory. Well, yeah, it's talked this place up the whole day.
No. No. We parked in front of it, and this is where we came, because that's how we roll.
I'm glad that they didn't have a spaghetti buffet, because this little kid over here would put them out of business. They'd have to close their doors. We're strolling the streets, trying to find some trouble to get into.
Didn't we, like, jump?
We did. Fighting over who gets to... And there's the Iowa sign. Welcome to Iowa. This is day 19. We are headed home today. We woke up in just outside of Omaha, Nebraska. And we have a little less than 10 hours to make it back to Selma, Indiana. I'm Des Moines, Iowa.
Meanwhile, I got this at a candy store.
Here's Antique Archaeology and their new brick shop with the old famous car right in front. We are not the only ones who want to see Mikey and Frankie. And there's the iconic building.
Iconic?
I think it is. The old Indian motorcycle. And an old Harley too, 39 Harley. My Indian frame up there. Kinds of rusted out frames.
Sorry.
Okay. Rust. They're not.
To buy these?
And the Mississippi River in all of its glory is right there.
Oh no!
Did you get it?
Yeah, kind of.
So close to being home. 29 minutes away from our crib. We left our whole trip, went all the way west, came all the way back. We've been stopped at one train, and that is in Muncie, Indiana. There's our house. Well done.
Oh, look at the yard. Looks so
yeah,
nice.
It does. Perfect.
The corn is so high.
Whoa, that's a big corn.
We'll be having corn tonight.
All right, so we're home. Love you guys. Good trip. And we're going to go enjoy some pizza that Olivia brought to us. Isn't that nice? Okay. Bye-bye.